they're ready.
Building Advisory Board meeting, May 8th, 2018. I call the meeting to order. Roll call. Do we need to do that?
Yes.
Start on this end. State your name.
Ryan White.
Kevin Cole.
Mark Frazier.
David Miller.
William McBride.
Rick Walters.
Scott Kraus.
Greg Nichols.
Mike Florey.
Okay, next item, approval of the minutes of the March 13th, 2018 meeting.
I move to approve the minutes.
Second.
Any discussion? All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye.
Minutes approved. New business. Refer to staff.
All right. Well, 2 months ago, we talked about the CSST code amendment. You guys approved it in general and directed staff to create ordinances for approval to the city commission. I'll just kind of read over my staff report here a little bit. The 2012 UPC and UMC have a new code section stating that all corrugated stainless steel tubing shall be bonded to the electrical service and grounding electrode system. That's attachment A. On 2/9/18, staff received a code amendment request from Mark Harris with Tight Flex Corporation requesting a change to this amendment. At the March 13th Building Advisory Board meeting, the board approved the amendment request and directed staff to create ordinances for review. Staff has created two ordinances for review to the BAB, attachments B and C, and we need to vote on those today to see if they meet your approval. They both say exactly the same thing, both these ordinances, with the exception of the UMC and UPC code sections in them. The code section, you can kind of look, they're in your packet there, but the new code section itself will read arc resistant jacketed CSST. CSST listed with an arc resistant jacket or coating system in accordance with ANSI LC1/CSA 6.26 fuel gas piping systems using corrugated stainless steel tubing shall be electrically continuous bonded to an effective ground fault circuit path where any CSST component of a piping system does not have an arc resistant jacket or coating system, the bonding requirements of 1210.15.2 shall apply. Arc resistant jacketed CSST shall be considered to be bonded when it is connected to the appliance that are connected to the appliance grounding conductor or circuit supplying that furnace. Okay, both these say the same thing, like I said, with the exception of the code reference sections because they're in two different codes. So, at this point, we can entertain a motion that would either A, vote to approve and recommend adoption by the City Commission, the Code Amendment Ordinances amending the 2012 UMC and 2012 UPC to provide a provision for arc-resistant jacketed CSST, relieving it from additional bonding requirements, or two, vote to disapprove and not recommend the adoption by the City Commission, the code amendment ordinances, and keep the bonding requirements as written in the 2012 and UMC and UPC.
Sean, that's verbatim out of the National Fuel Gas Code, is that correct?
Yes, it is.
I'd make a motion that we vote to approve that amendment. Is that what you needed?
Yeah, you can say either on the staff report there it says either number one or number two there.
We can leave it the same as it's written in the code.
So your motion is
to add this amendment to the code. However,
I'll second.
State that. You have a second.
Ryan, do you have anything on this?
Any discussion?
I'll second it.
It's already been seconded.
Oh, you did.
Anything from the public? All those in favor signify by saying aye.
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 Approved. Overview of City of Salina Board Ethics Policy.
All right. This is something that's not directed directly at the Building Advisory Board or anything. There wasn't any complaints saying that you guys needed a review of the Ethics Committee or policy or anything. It's something that we're going over all of our boards with. So I just wanted to print this off for you guys. You can read over it at your leisure. I don't know if you've already looked at it or not prior to the meeting. We sent this out last Friday. If you have questions about it or concerns about it, I'd be happy to talk about it now. I'm not going to sit here and read this whole 15-page document to you. I don't think anybody wants to sit there and listen to that. However, you know, the first part just goes through definitions and stuff like that, that it comes in here, talks about, you know, substantial interest, things like that, things you might want to abstain from, you know, in here if you have an interest in the topic at hand. General ethics, talks again more about substantial interest, common law, conflict, available legal resources. There's things in here about the city's legal counsel, things like that, how we refer back to them a lot. Anyway, you can look through this thing. It's like I say, it's like 15 pages long. There's also an attachment on the last two pages that talk about some other problems that other cities have had, City of Parsons, City of Topeka, City of Concordia, things like that, some law cases that have occurred that have to do with ethics and things like that that go along with boards. But with that, that's really kind of this in a nutshell here. I would highly encourage everyone to read over this and be familiar with that, so you kind of know, you know, what the city's policy is on ethics.
Any more discussion on this item? Moving on, unfinished or other business, there's none. We move on to public forum. Does the public have anything to say today? Saying that, I will entertain a motion for adjournment.
Well, hang on, there was one other thing I wanted to kind of go over here. We are just starting, actually just last week, there'll be commission meetings coming up forward. We're working very diligently on dangerous structures. Again, we're coming up with another list of houses to go before the city commission. I just kind of wanted to give you guys a heads up on what we were doing on that. We're working on dilapidated structures and dangerous structures right now. There'll be a list of about 10 houses, I think, this year that are going to go before the commission. Generally, I think last time we went through this, we had 20 houses to start with. I think we ended up demolishing 7. So the others, you know, worked themselves out. They'd made corrections or repairs or things like that. Anyway, I just kind of wanted to give everybody a heads up that we're out working on that again, trying to make Salina a cleaner and safer place.
So does this come through us?
No, it doesn't. Okay. I was just kind of giving you a heads up on what's going on. There's been a lot of people calling our office complaining about dilapidated structures and houses and things like that, and just kind of wanted to make it known to you guys, because you know you guys are out there in the field, the ones that are doing the work on a lot of places, and just wanted to let you know we were trying to be on top of it as best we can here. So
what's going on with the sprinkler system things? Are the guys applying for licenses now, or I mean, have you got that everything resolved with that?
Yes, that is put into place. Yeah, that went through the city commission, I don't know, a couple months ago. That's done, and it should be, let me see, I think we had a 180-day implementation period for that. because if we went for 90-day implementation, there wasn't enough test dates. There was only like one or two test dates in between then and the 90 days because they don't offer it that often.
Well, I know Russ from Landscape Consultants said something to me about either he wasn't getting the emails and wasn't sure about what was going on, so that's why I was asking.
Yeah, we did send out packets to all the sprinkler contractors in the area about that, and they should have gotten that. If he doesn't have the information, somehow didn't get it, he can definitely contact us and we'll get it for him. We'll send out a new packet to him.
Okay.
Anything else to come before the
there
board?
There was one other thing. We did have a youth member to the board. I think I mentioned last month that he was going to be coming on board. I think he's decided that he didn't have time in his schedule to fit it in, so now we don't have one. So if you guys have any ideas, if anybody you might know, high school, college age kids or whatever that that might like to to be a youth member on our board, we'd be happy to have them. So spread the word.
Okay.
Sean, what's this?
That's a packet that's been given out to, again, all the boards and commissions. I don't know if it has.
Oh, okay. This is it with the, okay.
Yeah.
This is the whole, all right.
Yeah.
Good enough.
I think the ethics policy was separate. That's just other rules and stuff that pertain to boards and commissions and things like that.
The ethics policy, I think, was in this one. But this is,
yeah.
This kind of goes through the whole.
Yeah.
And are we supposed to take these with us? Because Debbie said something about picking them up. Okay.
Anything else?
Hey, John, on permits and stuff, the new green system, is that getting in place?
Yes. Actually, our new permitting system started yesterday. So they're it's been a little bumpy right now. I think it's going to be a good system for us. We're kind of working out the kinks right now. As far as electronic plan submittal, that's still a little ways further out. We're still just working the kinks out on how everybody's going to do their plan reviews and entering permits and inspections and all that stuff. The guys all our field inspectors all have new tablets that they're working with out in the field. They're going to be entering inspections as they do them. Eventually here you'll be able to have a public portal, so where you'll be able to check your jobs whenever you want. Should be real live time, so you'll be able to know exactly where they're at, where you're at on every job. How inspections are, what the corrections were, if there were any, so on and so forth.
I was going to ask you, too, on slab-on-grade buildings, isn't the footing depth 30 inches still?
The frost depth is 36 inches since the adoption of the new code.
I thought it was. Somebody was asking me about that, if it was going to change, because they're getting ready to do that Popeye's chicken.
Mm-hmm.
And I told him I thought it was 36, and he was trying to tell me he thought it was 30.
That'd be incorrect.
I'll let him know.
Please be patient with us with Llama, because it's not exactly giving us all our schedules. And I know we've missed some inspections. And I was going to say, just please be patient with us, because we are trying to work out some kinks in it.
This is day two, so.
Yes. Of the hostage situation.
I would hope we'd have these bugs worked out within the next, very soon.
2 or 3 years.
Yeah. By the time we get a new system. But that's all I have, unless there's any other questions.
Anybody have anything else? I would entertain a motion for adjournment.
My motion is adjourned.
Here's a second.
Second.
All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Aye. Meeting is adjourned.